Welcome children. Today in this session we are going to see class 9 mathematics. What we have discussed in the previous class, chapter 2 polynomials. In that, what is polynomial and classification of polynomials based on number of terms that you know already, monomial, binomial, trinomial. If there is only one term in a polynomial, it is called monomial, and if it is two terms, okay, then it is binomial, and if a polynomial has three terms, then it is trinomial. So generally all are polynomials. It is based on number of terms and based on degree. Degree means what? The highest power, okay, of the variable in a polynomial. So based on the degree, we can classify as linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial. More than that, we have to name the number of the degree. If there is 4 degree, means degree 4 polynomial, 4th degree polynomial, 5th degree polynomial, like that we have to say. So specifically, if degree is 1, is it ax plus b, okay, x is the variable whose power is 1. So it is linear, so degree is 1. So general forms of linear polynomial, ax plus b, you see the first constant is coefficient of x not equal to 0. Why? If a is 0, then there will not be a x term. Quadratic polynomial, second degree polynomial is called quadratic polynomial. Ax square plus bx plus c is the general form. X square, that is must. So only the coefficient of x square a should not be 0. So that we have to mention. If we write in general form, because second degree means that x square should be there. Okay. So x square coefficient is a, that should not be 0. These things may or may not be there, but this is the general form, so you have to write completely. A x square plus b x plus c, a not equal to 0. This is the condition. And the cubic polynomial means x cube, that is third degree. So a x cube plus b x square plus c x plus d, where a not equal to 0. Here a becomes the coefficient of x cube term. Clear? So coefficient of x cube is a. So if a becomes 0, then we cannot get x cube term, the cubical term. So then how come you say that it is the third degree? Okay, so the coefficient of that particular degree term, okay, that is a, that should not be 0. So only the condition, when you write in general form, you have to write the condition with condition also. So these are the general forms, just you take it. And in this chapter, the second part, that is the topic we are going to see, zeros of a polynomial. What is the zeros? So zeros of a polynomial, you just take it quick. And now zeros of your polynomial. So zeros of your polynomial means what is that? In a polynomial, if the value becomes, the polynomial value becomes 0, then we can say that number which makes the polynomial 0 is called 0 of the polynomial. Just, it is somewhat difficult for you to understand, I know. Now I make it clear. Just write the definition. A number x equal to a, small x equal to small a, is called zero is called zero of the polynomial. P of x polynomial P of x if P of a equals 0 so this is the proper definition what is zeros of a polynomial so look here a number x equal to a is called zero of the polynomial P of x if P of a equal to 0 that means what P of x is a polynomial. You can take an example. Let equal to x minus 3. Okay, P of x equal to x minus 3. Yes, we are naming the polynomial. P of x means polynomial in x. That means the variable x. So, x minus 3 is a polynomial. So, x equal to a means any constant. A is nothing but any constant. Okay. Just I am putting it. At x equal to 3, P of 3 equal to. That means what? I am taking or I am substituting 3 for x. So x equal to 3. At x equal to 3. So here, instead of x, put 3. So P of 3. That means what? Wherever you see x, you have to put 3. So P of 3 is equal to 3 minus 3 which is equal to 0. So now the value of the polynomial becomes 0 by which constant, by which number? 3. Clear? When we put 3 instead of x, 3 minus 3 becomes 0. Therefore the given polynomial vanishes. That means the value of the polynomial becomes 0. Okay? When we substitute 3, so which makes the polynomial 0 means here in this polynomial 3 when we substitute for x okay when we substitute for x equal to 3 then the polynomial value becomes 0 therefore we can say therefore 3 is a 0 of p of x here the p of x that you know what is that x minus 3 So, 3 is a 0 of P of x. So, here the definition you just recall. A number x equal to a is called 0 of the polynomial P of x. If P of a equal to 0, that means what? X equal to a. Therefore, here you substitute a instead of x, P of a will come. So, the value of P of a should be 0. Then we can say this a is the 0 of polynomial. Clear? So, now you see x minus 3 is the given P of x. If you put 3 instead of x, the value becomes 0. The polynomial value becomes 0. So we are saying 3 is a 0 of P of x. Which makes the value of polynomial 0, 3. When you put 3, then the value of the polynomial becomes 0. So 3 is a 0 of P of x. So this is the meaning of zeros of polynomial. Don't confuse 0 polynomial and zeros of polynomial. The previous class, we have discussed zero polynomial. Zero polynomial means what? For example, zero, the number zero, okay, the number zero is a zero polynomial. When it will come like that, for example, if you take any polynomial, generally, general polynomial, for example, a x square, you take this, the same polynomial, okay, a x square plus b x plus c, clear? If all the coefficients is a, here b, here c, when all the coefficients or you can say all the constants, variable is x, okay, the term is ax square, but the variable is x, x only. We are dealing with only the polynomial in one variable. So the variable is x here. So the constants are, that is nothing but the coefficients. Here a, coefficient of x square, b, coefficient of x and c is the constant. If all these constants a, b, c are 0, that means you say a equal to b equal to c equal to 0, then what happened? 0 into x square 0, this becomes 0 plus 0 plus 0, so everything becomes 0. So that is called 0 polynomial. 0 is called 0 polynomial. But here, this topic is zeros of a polynomial. difference is there. Don't confuse. Okay? Zeros of a polynomial. Zeros of a polynomial means which number or which constant makes the polynomial, given polynomial, zero. That is the zero of the polynomial. So here 3 is a zero. This is some example. Okay. So we will see in the exercise also. At the time, we will practice a lot and you can come to understand very clear. And now, just to get it, this alone. Okay, this is an explanation only. All these things in here. Clear? And now, solving the polynomial equation by taking p of x equal to 0. Okay, let me see. So solving the polynomial equation by taking p of x equal to 0. So this is the way of making or finding the zero of the given polynomial. Step. Okay. So let's example. Okay. So let's take any polynomial p of x is equal to 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3 is a generally we are taking any polynomial as p of x equal to 2x plus 3. If p of x is equal to 0, then 2x plus 3 equal to 0. You see, when we make p of x is 0, then we get, if this is 0, then the right side 2x plus 3 will become 0. So when 2x plus 3 is 0, then easily we can find 2x equal to minus 3 and x equal to minus 3 by 2. See, minus 3 by 2. So minus 3 by 2, when we substitute here, then automatically we get 0. That you know, you see, 2 into minus 3 by 2. X is minus 3 by 2. So when we substitute x here, minus 3 by 2. Clear? For x, put minus 3 by 2. 2 into minus 3 by 2 plus 3. What happens? Cancel. Then you get minus 3 plus 3, which is nothing but 0. So what it says, when we substitute minus 3 by 2 for x, the value of the polynomial becomes 0. Therefore, minus 3 by 2 is nothing but 0 of the polynomial fx. So therefore, you can say minus 3 by 2 is a 0 of fx. Okay, trial and error is there. If the polynomial is very simple, then trial, this is for understanding only, no need to take this. So how to find the zero of the polynomial means, so directly, by equating the polynomial to zero, then this becomes also zero. When this p of x, if you put zero, then 2x plus 3, the right hand side, whatever it is there, you will equate to zero. And you try to find the x. Okay. So x, we get minus 3 by 2. So minus 3 by 2 is 0 of p of x, and I have explained how it is. When you substitute minus 3 by 2 for x, we get the value 0. Therefore p of x 0, what we have taken is correct. So minus 3 by 2 is 0 of p of x. This is nothing but the way of finding 0 of a given polynomial. If it is p of x is equal to x minus 2, then it is very easy. Okay, if you put 2, For x, the 2 minus 2 becomes 0. So by trial and error method also we can say. But the way of finding the correct step is, this is the way. So how to find the 0 of the given polynomial, any point. Clear? So you have to know this. This will help you to do the exercise problems. And you take this also. Solving the polynomial equation by taking p of x is equal to 0. So this is the way of finding 0 of the given polynomial. So this will help you to find, for example, find the 0 of p of x equal to ax plus b. Suppose it is given like this. The polynomial p of x equal to ax plus b, and they are asking to find the 0 of the given p of x. So how to do this solution? P of x is given ax plus b. If p of x equal to 0, then we can take the right hand side ax plus b is equal to 0. Clear? And then ax is equal to minus b, and then x is equal to minus b by a. Isn't that, you know how to transpose, side transposing and all? Ax plus b equal to 0, and keeping ax, we are going to find x only. So ax is equal to this b becomes minus b when transposing to the right side, and keeping x here, you see ax or multiplying, so a into x. So keeping x here, transpose a to the right side, so it will go to the denominator. So minus b by a is the x value. Now x equal to minus b by a, we got it. So now easily you can say, therefore, minus b by a is a 0 of the given polynomial p of x. So this is the way of finding. Already I gave you an example. So this is the linear polynomial. You see, ax plus b is what? Linear polynomial, because the degree is 1. Variable is x. You see, x, p of x. So x is the variable whose highest power is 1. So degree is 1. You know, highest power means degree. So therefore, it is a linear polynomial. So linear polynomial has only one zero. One and only one zero. That is the only one zero. Minus b by a is the zero of p of x. So the number of zeros for the given polynomial depends on the nature of the degree of the given polynomial. So here degree 1, that is linear polynomial, degree 1. So one zero will be there. Minus b by a is a zero of p of x. And we will take some point. Okay. And now we are coming to see some notable points. Every linear polynomial has unique zero. Just now with example I have explained to you zero polynomial and what is zeros of polynomial, and also linear polynomial has only one zero. Clear? Ax plus b, and x is only the variable, degree is 1, and if you substitute, okay, to find 0 equal to 0, then we get what? Minus b by a is the 0 of the linear polynomial, general linear polynomial. So every linear polynomial has unique 0. Next, a non-zero constant polynomial has no 0. So non-zero means other than 0. So constant. Any constant number we can take. For example, if you take 15 is a constant, you cannot make p of x 0 by substituting any number. Clear? Because no variable is there. P of x means polynomial in variable x. But here only the constant is there, no variable. X is not there. So if you put any real number, p of x never becomes 0. So not equal to 0 for any real number. Therefore, it has no 0. So only a non-zero constant polynomial has no 0. Clear? Next point. A polynomial can have more than one 0. Already I told you. Okay. depending upon its nature, that means if it is a linear polynomial, then it's degree 1 polynomial, so 1 0 will be there. That's the first point, says has unique 0. And in the second degree polynomial means at most 2 zeros will be there, because it is second degree. Second degree means quadratic. And next, cubic polynomial, third degree. So 3 zeros will be there, and it proceeds such that way. And generally we can say a polynomial can have more than one zero depending upon its nature. Next, every real number is a zero of the zero polynomial. Already told you just now, zero is nothing but zero polynomial. If zero is there, means p of x is equal to zero, this is the polynomial, zero polynomial, there is no variable. Okay, suppose if you substitute any constant, any real number, what happens if you multiply with any real 0 into any real number? Suppose take small a is any real number, then you get 0 only. Therefore, you can say every real number is a 0 of the 0 polynomial. Because if you put any real number, if you multiply with any real number, then also the value becomes 0 only. 0 into anything is 0. So we can say every real number is a 0 of the 0 polynomial. Clear? And then next point, just see what is there. A 0 of a polynomial need not be 0. Clear? Don't think that 0 only the 0 of the polynomial. The number 0 only the 0 of the polynomial. It's not like that. May be or may not be. For example, let's now we have seen that. If p of x equal to 3x minus 2 or any number, okay, 3x minus 2. Try to find the 0 of this means, what happens? We have to put 3x minus 2 equal to 0, then 3x is equal to 2, you see, and x equal to 2 by 3. So, 2 by 3 is a 0 of this polynomial p of x. Okay. So here 0 is not there. Okay. So we cannot say 0 of a polynomial only 0. So only a 0 of a polynomial need not be 0. It may be 0 or may not. So here we are getting 2 by 3 is a 0 of this p of x. And coming to the next point, 0 may be the 0 of a polynomial. Maybe p of x, if you take a 3x, okay, 3x is the polynomial, given polynomial, it is a linear polynomial, 3x, yeah. So if you put x equal to 0, what happens? 3 into 0 then becomes 0, so the value becomes 0. Therefore, for what number the value of the polynomial becomes 0? The number 0. Okay, the number 0 makes the polynomial 0. Therefore, 0 is the 0. We just make the difference. Here 0 is the number. Is 0 means, okay, 0 of the polynomial p of x. So 0 is the 0 of the polynomial p of x. Clear? Because of this number 0, the value or the polynomial vanish. The value of the polynomial becomes 0. So we can just say 0 may be the 0 of the polynomial or may not be 0. So sometimes it comes 0 itself, 0 of the polynomial. Okay. In many things like this, you will get. So these are the wonderful points. And now coming to the exercise 2.2. Just to take all these points, it will be helpful while doing the exercise. Just to see exercise 2.1, which of the following, okay, they are asking, 2.2, so find the value of the polynomial 2.2 first sum, find the value of the polynomial 5x
value of the polynomial five x minus four x square plus three at option one, x equal to zero. Option two, x equal to minus one. Option three, this given x equal to two. So the options are there. We have to substitute. So solution, let p of x is equal to, we have to take the given polynomial 5x minus x, sorry, 4x square plus 3. 5x minus 4x square plus 3, it is given there. And now first option, x equal to 0, so you have to take at x equal to 0, comma, what is p of 0? Yeah, at x equal to 0, that means what? Instead of x, put 0. So p of 0 is equal to, what happens? Wherever you find x, you put 0. So 5 into 0 minus 4 into 0 square plus 3. Instead of x, you put 0, that's all. And what happens? 5 into 0, 0 minus 4 into 0 square means that also 0. And then we get 3. So this is, which is, find the value, that's the value, that's all. So here 3 is the value of the polynomial when x equal to 0. So like that we have to find option 2, x equal to minus 1 is given. So we can say at x equal to minus 1, p of minus 1 is equal to, p of x is there. So if you put minus 1, then here also right side 5 into minus 1 minus 4 into minus 1 whole square plus 3. So just we are doing a simple thing, just substitute the given value for x, and what happens? 5 into minus 1 minus 5 minus 4 minus 1 whole square, 4 into minus 1 whole square, minus 1 whole square minus, that means the minus 1 into minus 1 we get plus 1, right? So just we put 1, minus 1 whole square is nothing but 1, minus 1 into minus 1, what happens? If you have any doubt, just you put like this in the right side, rough call, okay, minus 1 into minus 1 is nothing but minus 1 whole square, so minus into minus plus 1 into 1, 1, okay, so just we put 1 here, that's all, and then plus 3, again minus 5, minus 4, minus 4 into 1, minus 4, and then plus 3, see what happens, minus 5, minus 4, you get minus 9, and then plus 3, and again minus 9 plus 3 is minus 6, clear? That's the value. So minus 6 is the value of this polynomial p of x when x equal to, or at x equal to minus 1. So like that we can easily find for third option what is the value of the polynomial. It's a very easy one. So option 3, at x equal to, what the value? 2. 2. You can write at the bottom also. P of 2 equal to, what happens? It is up to 2. P of 2. Here x equal to 2. Here also x is 2. So 5 into 2 minus 4 into 2 square and then plus 3. Can you understand? And now what happens? 5 into 2, 10. The calculation is very important. Minus 4 into 2 square, what happens? 2 square is 4. So minus 4 into 4, step by step you proceed, okay? Then only you won't come to mistake. So 10, you see 10 plus 3, what happens? 13. What? 13. And then minus 4 into 4, 16. Clear? Positive value, just we add. Negative value is only 1. So minus 4 into 4, minus 16. And what happens now? So which is the bigger value, positive or negative? Negative. So put minus. And what is the difference of 16 and 13? 3. So that's all. So this is the way of finding the value of the given polynomial at the given value of x. So, so this is the way of finding the solution. And coming to question number 2, find p of 0, p of 1, p of 2 for each of the following polynomial. So here, what is the difference of first and second sum means? Here only one polynomial is given, so we are taking and assuming as p of x. And three different values of x are given, and they are asking to find the value of the polynomial for these three different values. But this next question, more options, I think four options are given there. Four options, so four different polynomials, and they are asking to find p of 0 means x equal to 0. You have to put that x equal to 0. Suppose if you find any variable other than y or t, you have to put 0, okay, for that variable, and 1 and then 2. 0, 1, 2. P of 0, P of 1, P of 2. So you have to find. So I will do for you any one sum, and remaining you have to take that sum. So this is the first sum. Take the notes then and there. Then only easy to submit in time. Okay? Don't postpone anything. So now coming to question number 2. Find P of 0, P of 1, and P of 2. And P of 2 for each of the following polynomial. For each of the following polynomial. Option 1. What's the polynomial given? P of y equal to y square minus y plus 1. So this is the polynomial given here. And we have to find the value, that is P of 0, P of 1, P of 2. Here. So at y equal to 0, you have, because the variable given here is y. So at y equal to 0, then P of 0 will come. P of 0 is equal to what happens? 0 whole square minus 0 plus 1. Then this is 0 minus 0 plus 1. And final answer is 1. P of 0 is 1. And at y equal to what? 1. Then we can find P of 1. That is nothing but 1 square minus 1 plus 1. So instead of y, put 1. And now 1 square is 1 minus 1 plus 1. You see, 1 minus 1 gets cancelled, and the answer is 1. So the value of P of y at y equal to 1 is 1. And coming to the next step, at y equal to 2, because we are going to find P of 2, they are asking that. So P of 2 is equal to, for y, put 2, 2 square minus 2 plus 1. So 2 square means 4, and then minus 2 plus 1. Now the positive values are 4 and 1. So 4 plus 1, 5, and then minus 2. And which is nothing but 3. So now at y equal to 2, P of 2 is 3 for this polynomial. So first option works. So like that we have to do option 2, 3 and 4. And I will do option 4 for you. The remaining two homework. Clear? Option 4. It is given P of x equal to x minus 1 into x plus 1. Clear? X minus 1 into x plus 1. So you can leave as it is, or if you want, you can simplify. So what is this? X minus 1 to x plus 1. It looks like a minus b to a plus b identity. So a square minus b square. So your x square minus 1 will come. Okay. And then at x equal to first 0, you have to find. Right? First 0, p of 0. So at x equal to 0, comma p of 0 is equal to what happened? X square means 0 square minus 1. This is nothing but 0 minus 1 means equal to minus 1. Clear? At x equal to 1, what happens? P of 1 equal to x square minus 1. So instead of x put 1, so 1 square minus 1. 1 square is 1 and then minus 1. This is nothing but 0. And then next, at x equal to 2, p of 2 equal to, p of 2 is equal to what happens? 2 square minus 1. For x put 2, so 2 square minus 1. So 2 into 2, 4 minus 1, it is nothing but 3. So now we have found the value of the polynomial p of x for 0, 1, 2. So p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, we have found it. Clear? So the remaining two options will take us forward. And coming to the next sum, question number 3. See what is given there, just read out. So question number 3, verify whether the following are zeros of the polynomial. We have to verify whether the following are zeros of the polynomial indicated against them means, indicated against them. It is given in the question, just read out. So straight to the given polynomial, the question itself, they have indicated what is the value of x, that is minus 1 by 3, first sum, option 1. Question number 3, option 1. P of x is equal to, what is given there? P of x is equal to 3x plus 1. Clear? 3x plus 1. Comma, x equal to minus 1 by 3. Yes. X equal to minus 1 by 3. So, indicated against the means, against means straight to this polynomial. P of x is the polynomial, 3x plus 1. So, after comma, x equal to minus 1 by 3 is given straight to this. So, that's called indicated against them. So, first of all, you have to understand the question. So, verify whether the following are zeros of the polynomial. That means what? X equal to minus 1 by 3, if you substitute in this polynomial, whether it will be a zero or not. That's why that alone they are asking. Clear? So, at x equal to minus 1 by 3. Okay. P of minus 1 by 3 is equal to. So what we have to do, just to substitute the given value against the polynomial. Okay. Minus 1 by 3 equal to 3 into, what's the polynomial? 3 into x. So 3 into minus 1 by 3. So x is minus 1 by 3. So 3 into minus 1 by 3 plus 1. And you now see what happened? 3 into minus 1 by 3. So 3, 3 gets cancelled, the numerator and denominator. Clear? Minus 1 only there. Minus 1 plus 1 and again is equal to 0. So now the value of the polynomial become 0. So we can say therefore the value indicated against the given polynomial x equal to minus 1 by 3. Okay, is that right? X equal to minus 1 by 3 is a 0 of what? P of x. So in this sum, P of x is 3x plus 1, that you know. So x equal to minus 1 by 3. So minus 1 by 3 is a 0 of P of x. That's all. The indicated value of x minus 1 by 3 is a 0 of this polynomial P of x. And just like that, we will do that. Option 5, yes, option 5, x square, a of x equal to x square. X square is given and the value indicated against them is x equal to 0. So x equal to 0 means this implies p of 0. So for x put 0. So 0 square, which is nothing but 0. So the value of the polynomial becomes 0 when x equal to 0. Therefore, what? 0 is there. Therefore, x equal to 0 is a 0 of p of x. What is p of x here? X square. Like that is fine. And the next option 6. P of x is equal to Lx plus m. And against to that, it is given x equal to minus m by u. Okay, so this implies p of minus m by l equal to the indicated value of x is minus m by l. So you have to substitute here. So l into what is x? Minus m by l. So minus m by l plus m. So look here, this l is in the numerator and this l is in the denominator. So like this, we can cancel 3 and 3, like that here, l and l, we can cancel it. Clear? After that, minus m is there and then plus m already is there. Now, minus m plus m is what? 0. Okay. Same quantity, opposite sign. Always 0. Therefore, we can say x equal to minus m by l is a 0 of p of x. Clear? So like that, you have to take. And one more sum I will do for you. In option 7, it is given two values are there. Okay, we will see. Two values are there. Option 7. You see, p of x is equal to 3x squared minus 1. X is equal to minus 1 by root 3. Another value, 2 by root 3. So this is what given here. And we have to find whether they are the 0 of a polynomial or not. So first, we substitute minus 1 by root 3. At x equal to minus 1 by root 3, p of x, that is p of minus 1 by root 3 is equal to 3 into what is x? Minus 1 by root 3. So minus 1 by root 3 whole square and then minus 1. You see, 3x square minus 1 is there. So 3 into for x minus 1 by root 3 and then whole square minus 1. What happens is, listen carefully, 3 as it is 3. So in this bracket, minus sign is there. So when we take square for minus, it becomes plus. Minus into minus, plus. Okay. And within bracket, to avoid confusion, within bracket, minus becomes plus. And 1 becomes 1 into 1. If you apply 1, sorry, if you apply square for 1, we get 1 only. So put 1, 5. And root 3 is in the denominator. When we apply square for root 3, you know what happens in the number system. We have learned it. What will come? 3. Root 3 into root 3. That is root 3 whole square. So root 3 into root 3 is 3. So we will get 3 here. And then minus 1 is there. So this numerator 3, denominator 3 gets cancelled, and the remaining is 1, and also there minus 1, which is nothing but 0. 1 minus 1, 0. Therefore, we can say minus 1 by root 3, okay, is a 0 of this p of x. Why? Because when we put minus 1 by root 3, the value of the polynomial becomes 0. So that is the definition of zeros of a polynomial. So we can say, therefore, 0 is, what is, sorry, here, minus 1 by root 3, x equal to minus 1 by root 3 is a 0 of p of x. Clear? Minus 1 by root 3 is a 0 of p of x. So what about the next 2 by root 3? So 2 by root 3, if you substitute, what happens? You just see. At x equal to 2 by root 3. Okay, the next value. Minus 1 by root 3, we have found it. And now coming to the next one, 2 by root 3. Come on, what happens? P of 2 by root 3 is equal to, the polynomial is P of x equal to 3x square minus 1. So 3 into, for x square you have tried 2 by root 3 whole square, and then minus 1 is there. Clear? And now let it be 3, and then the whole square, so you have to remove it. If you apply square for the numerator 2, what happens? 2 into 2, 4. Why? Root 3 means, if you apply square, get 3, that's all. And again, this 3 gets cancelled. So 4 minus 1, which is equal to 3, and this is not equal to 0. This is 3 only, it is not equal to 0. So 2 by root 3, when x equal to 2 by root 3, the value of the polynomial is not equal to 0. What is the value of the polynomial? 3, which is not equal to 0. Therefore, this x equal to 2 by root 3 is not a 0. Therefore, x equal to 2 by root 3 is not a 0 of the given polynomial p of x. You see, for this polynomial p of x, when x equal to minus 1 by root 3, then the value becomes 0. So we can say x equal to minus 1 by root 3 is a 0 of the given polynomial p of x. But the next value, for x equal to 2 by root 3, the value is not equal to 0. Therefore, if it is not equal to 0, the value of the polynomial is not equal to 0, then we can say x equal to 2 by root 3 is not a 0 of p of x. Here, minus 1 by root 3 makes the value of polynomial 0. Therefore, we can say x equal to minus 1 by root 3 is a 0 of p of x. Here, not like that. So, is not a 0 of p of x. That's all. So, coming to fourth one. Fourth sum. Okay. Thus, we will see. Fourth sum, find the zero of polynomial in each of the following cases. Very easy. Okay, fourth sum. Here, let's stop there. Fourth sum. First option, p of x equal to x plus 5. So, what they are asking? They have given the polynomial and they are asking to find zero of the polynomial in each case. How to find zero? The very beginning, I have given an example how to find, one step is there, how to find the zero of the given polynomial. So, this you know, directly we can say very simple polynomial. So, for x equal to minus 5, when we put minus 5 for x, what happens? Minus 5 plus 5 becomes 0. Then minus 5 is the 0 of the polynomial p of x. Like that we can easily say. Okay, but anyhow, so the step we have to write. Okay. So if it is one mark means no need. That way we can easily say minus 5 is the 0 of the given polynomial p of x. Suppose in any other sense, it is better to write in the procedure. So if p of x equal to 0, then x plus 5 equal to 0. This is solving for x, the given equation, p of x 0. So when p of x is 0, then we can put x plus 5 equal to 0. This is 0. And then x equal to minus 5. So that's what I already told you, minus 5 is the 0 of the p of x. So easily we can say here minus 5 is the 0 of p of x. Clear? So minus 5 is the 0 of p of x. P of x means what? Here the p of x is x plus 5. So every time p of x I am writing is that p of x is in the given sum p of x. So this is finished, that's why. So here p of x is x plus 5. Clear? So this is the way of finding the 0 of the given polynomial. One more sum. P of x is equal to 3x minus 2. That is option 4. P of x is equal to 3x minus 2. So if P of x equal to 0, then 3x minus 2 equal to 0. So 3x equal to 2, x equal to 2 by 3. You see how I got it? The value of x. So solving x plus 1. So therefore, okay, 2 by 3 is the 0 of this p of x. Clear or not? And then coming to the next, p of x equal to ax, option 6. P of x equal to ax. So how to do this? If p of x is equal to 0, come on, you can have ax equal to 0. X equal to what? 0 by a, 0. Or you can write here if it is not visible. So here I am writing. So you get x equal to 0 by a, so x equal to 0. Clear or not? Ax equal to 0, then x equal to 0 by a, so x equal to 0. 0 by anything is 0. So therefore, what we can say? Here 0 is what? X equal to 0, we have got it. So 0 is the 0 of p of x. Therefore, 0 is the 0 of p of x. So when we put 0 here for x, a into 0 becomes 0. So like that, this is the way of finding the 0 of the given polynomial. So the steps I have taken. And the last one, option 7. I think you can do by yourself the remaining things. As homework, very few sums only I am giving, and watch it also will be sent to you when you have to do it. So the last one, option 7, you see what is given there, p of x equal to cx plus b. Okay, so if p of x equal to 0, then we can write, this implies cx plus b equal to 0. So cx equal to minus b, that you know, plus b by transposing to the right side, minus b. Here c into x, so take c to the right side, it will go to the denominator, so minus b by c. You see, this is the what? The final solution of x. So therefore, you can write what? Minus b, okay, by c is the 0 of this polynomial p of x. That's all. So this is the way of doing. So we have finished exercise 2.2. Worksheet will be sent to you. So then and there you complete your notebooks. Okay, then only it will be quite easy for you to submit whenever it is asked to submit. So thank you, children. Keep on practicing.